With recess underway at a school in Miami, Florida, Jonathan, a grade 4 student, is lost in play.
Let's go.
Bob Apfel was one of the grade 4 teachers at Crestview Elementary School. The bell had already gone, and Bob was trying to get kids into class.
Everyone inside, come on.
Jonathan sees the same strange shape now off in the distance.
Didn't look as though the object was about to crash or land or come down anywhere near the school. It was still some distance away.
Let's go, come on, guys. You're late already, let's go. Thank you.
What the heck is that?
Are you seeing this?
Young lady, inside, please. Jonathan, come on. Inside, sir. What's wrong, Jonathan?
Mr. Apple, what is that?
Bob Apfel knew straight away this was something out of the ordinary.
There were various airfields around the school, so you would be familiar with aircraft in the air, what they look like.
Suddenly, the object just disappeared. They weren't sure whether it had just flown off so quickly that they couldn't keep track of it, or whether it had in fact actually vanished into thin air. There was an element of shock, an element of disbelief. They needed to go back to their normal daily routine while they processed what it was that they had just seen.
But what happened the next day, that's what really makes this case stand out.
As well, I'm happy to announce that $35 was raised for band instruments. So thanks to all who participated in our rally.
It's back!
This time, it's a different sighting.
For one thing, the sighting is much closer.
Something like 200, 250 yards away from the school property.
For another, it's brought company.
This time there was more than one.
Dad, I think they're getting bigger.
There was one larger object and two smaller objects, and the two were acting like escorts. People saw something they couldn't describe or have never seen before.
The larger object suddenly slows to a near stop.
Just hovering in the air, not very far away from some trees on the other side of the street from the school.
Where'd it go? The witness described the objects leaving the area by simply disappearing.
It was there a minute ago.
It's not a very long experience, probably something like 30 seconds. Perhaps a minute.
Amidst the chaos,
what is going on?
Mr. Apfel finally arrives.
They're back.
And kids go rushing out of the classroom.
While Mr. Apfel races off to warn the principal, the kids reach the edge of the schoolyard.
Oh, there it is!
where the largest of the three objects reappears, offering them a perfect view.
Above the cigar shape, there was a sort of turreted structure, as if it was a dome or a small tower on top of the object. And what happened next was something utterly unexpected. It actually flew into one of the trees.
Where'd it go?
I can't see anything.
The tree didn't move. There was no damage to the tree that could be seen.
I just saw it. I understand.
And then the saucer came out of the tree. There was no damage to the flying saucer. The tree had somehow absorbed the flying saucer and then ejected it out. Was something that was really beyond their comprehension. There was this definite sense of wonder and excitement. The object was able to ascend to a certain height and then take off at incredible speed. Some of the witnesses have very clear memories of there being a strong military presence at the school over that afternoon. They interviewed three of the teachers who were direct witnesses to what had been seen.
The Air Force said, well, if it hovers, it must be a helicopter, therefore it is a helicopter. But it makes no sense. The helicopter would make noise. The helicopter would be easily identifiable to the witnesses. They weren't that far away from it.
The testimonies of the teacher witnesses still exist and they can be seen today on the internet.
The following day, a group of local residents report yet another sighting around 9:45 a.m. Once again, involving three flying saucer-like objects near the schoolyard. UFO researchers later learn that Project Blue Book, the U.S. military's official UFO investigation body, confirmed the Air Force's official explanation that the sightings were in fact Coast Guard helicopters on maneuvers. The explanation is flatly rejected by many of the original witnesses, both students and teachers. Over 40 years later, as adults, many have begun to discuss the case in public and online for the very first time.